Hey guys, it's Celine here, and today I am sitting down to talk to you guys about something incredible that happened to me a week ago on last Friday night. I hung out with Taylor Swift for the #1989 Secret Sessions in her New York City apartment with her for a solid 7 to 8 hours. Yep. I still can't believe I could say those words and have them be true. So getting that phone call on Wednesday, 2 days prior to Friday, was a big shock. The reason I went was because of my best friend Fiona, who I'm going to insert a clip of her here, just talking about her experience getting the phone call.
Hey guys, it's Fiona, here to talk about my Taylor experience. So on Tuesday night, I got a phone call, and it was from Taylor Nation, and they were asking, like, they had my contact information, I guess from something I'd entered previously, I'm not really sure how, but they had my cell phone number. So I answered, and they asked if it was Fiona, and I said yes. And then they asked if I was free that Friday for a Taylor event, but they couldn't really tell me any more information about it. So of course I got really, really excited and started freaking out. And since I was under 18, they said that I either had to bring like a parent or a guardian, or I had to bring someone who was 16 or older. So they said, okay, so are you gonna bring like your mom or your dad? And I was like, no. I said, I'm gonna take Celine. So I gave them Celine's contact information and her cell phone number and her email address and all of that.
So fast forward to Friday afternoon, Fiona and I, we go up the escalators and we see a crowd of girls and some guys just dressed nicely, like waiting anxiously, like looking around, looking on their phones, and we're like, okay, this is the place. Like, this is what everyone's here for. No one's acknowledging it, but we're like, we all know we're all here for one thing, and that is Taylor Swift. And I just made so many amazing friends that night. So here are some pictures of the friends that I made. Like, we text each other every 2 minutes, like on Tumblr and then this other messaging site. So we just are constantly in this huge group chat. So thanks to Taylor Swift on that entire night, I made a whole new set of friends. Finally are escorted into her home. And let me tell you, it was like stepping into the afterlife. I'm like, this is it, RIP me, I'm dead. Like, it actually felt like heaven because they opened the doors and you just hear this like blast of euphemism, like good music playing, really good smell of food. Like, there was sushi, there were chicken nuggets, there were so many good delicious foods, and it just smelled like Taylor Swift would smell, like autumn, fall, candles everywhere. There were so many candles, let me tell you. Also, there was at least like 12 or 13 candles, probably 13 knowing Taylor, but it was just so awesome. And to say the least about her apartment, because I do want to respect her privacy and not really give too much about her home in general, because it is a private thing, you know, but it was an Anthropology store except more Taylor Swift eyes. So they said, like, you can walk around the entire apartment except for the second floor, because that's where her bedroom is. And obviously, like, I understood that. I mean, we were in her apartment, for crying out loud. Like, I understood anything. I was okay with everything, basically. So just like walking around her living room, her kitchen was spacious. Like, it was just so awesome. I'm like, wow, like, this is it. Like, that's the piano she wrote all these songs to. There's throw pillows everywhere on the floor, and then there was this giant chair along with a giant Bose speaker next to it. So we're like, okay, she's probably playing the album, like, from like other sessions that we've read about on Tumblr and Instagram and Twitter and stuff like that. So we know she's playing the album. So we sit down, we find a spot. I would say I was like third or fourth row. There's a Polaroid picture of me and like the first few rows just like waving to the camera. So here's a picture of that, by the way. So that's where I was. I was sitting behind Zach and Patty and Kate and like all these other people that I became friends with. This one girl go, I heard that Karlie Kloss is in the apartment. And I'm like, okay, that's such a rumor. Like, who started that? And to my disbelief, Taylor Swift comes down her stairs along with supermodel Victoria's Secret Karlie Kloss, and they're just walking side by side because, you know, they're both already so tall and perfect. So it was like already unbelievable to see Taylor Swift, but then also supermodel Karlie Kloss. Like, what? Sit down to talk to us, and she's like, so I was thinking I could play the album for you guys if that's okay. So during the entire album playing, she explained each song to us, like the inspiration behind them, like the backstories behind the songs, and just like all these personal things. And by the way, if you want like a little like exclusive on 1989, it is so incredibly personal, but it is so well done. Like, there's no bashing of people. It's just so respectful but so powerful at the same time. Like, it really sends a message. And 1989, I think, honestly, my favorite album. So then she does this like little intro was her mission, and she's like, you know, you can take this time now to go to the bathroom, stretch your legs, whatever you gotta do. And we're like, okay, yeah, we're gonna stretch our legs, all right, yeah, we're talking to you. Like, that's what we're doing the entire time. And it was just so intimate. Like, it wasn't like a crowd of fans being like, oh, Taylor, Taylor. Like, it was just so casual. It was like seeing a friend that you have not seen in a long time and just asking them questions about what they've been up to, like what they've been doing. While that was happening and she was just talking to other people, I was just waiting right behind. I was just like staring at her dress, and then out of nowhere she turns around, points at me and goes, hey, will you follow me into the kitchen? And I go, yes, 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 of course I'll follow you into the kitchen. Like, I just turned around and we started walking together into her kitchen, and I'm like, you know, Taylor, you are the very foundation of me and my best friend's friendship. Like, because of you, I'm best friends with my friend Fiona, who is here tonight, but right now she's in the bathroom. And she just starts laughing. She's like, oh, okay. And I was like, Taylor, like, you are beautiful inside and out. You're completely inspirational to every single person, and I just really want to thank you for everything that you've done. And she was just like, oh, like, you're so beautiful inside and out too. Like, you have like this little baby doll face. Like, I love you. Like, thank you so much for coming. And she just thanked everyone for coming so many times, which is seriously so humble of her. Like, if anything, we should be thanking her, which we did. But like, she was more thanking us for coming to her apartment. Like, how crazy is that? So then she goes, okay, so the main reason I wanted to call you into the kitchen is because, like, I saw you were like jamming out and stuff, and I was wondering if you could pass out cookies. And I'm like, oh, like, did you make the cookies? And she's like, yeah, I made these cookies and treats, so I was wondering if you could help me pass them out. And I'm like, okay, I'll be passing out these cookies. And by the way, those cookies, Taylor, if you're watching this, A+. Thank you for that recipe on Tumblr, by the way. I'm totally making that when I can, because that was A+. I'm like turning over to me, like thanking me for holding these cookies, and I'm like, thank you for being in my presence. And then time comes, like Taylor Swift turns to us, and I go, Taylor, like, this is my best friend Fiona that I was talking to you about. Like, here she is, like, in the flesh, like, here she is. And Taylor goes, hi, and we just start talking, and Fiona starts talking to Taylor about, like, how, like, inspirational she is, and just, like, all these nice things to her, and Taylor said the same things back to Fiona. Like, it was just so awesome. And then we started talking about this casual thing. Like, we started talking about Halloween at some point. I was like, oh, like, what are you gonna be for Halloween? And she's like, I don't know. Like, it's either gonna be something really scary or really funny. And I was like 6'4", and I'm like 5'1", 5'2". So she's just like looking me up and down and going, I think you'd look good in an animal costume. Like, you know, like a full-on animal costume. And I go, okay, I'll take that into consideration, I guess. Then we go back to our seats. Someone had stolen my seat, but honestly, I didn't really care because it was just like a good view either way. 5 feet more behind now, it doesn't matter. Like, I'm still hearing the same amazing content. I'm still seeing Taylor Swift live. Like, this is okay. To conclude the entire album, she's like, you know what, I think we should have a dance party. And she just turns on Shake It Off, and everyone gets up from their seats. And to be honest with you, I am a terrible, terrible dancer. Like, I have no rhythm. Like, I suck at dancing. If anything, this is my best way of dancing. Like, going like this, like this, like this. Like, I'm terrible at dancing. And so Fiona and I, she's also not that great of a dancer either. And she knows it too, so it's okay. And so we just look at each other and we're like, we're not gonna pretend to like know what we're doing. We're just gonna go all out. So I look over at Fiona and she starts flailing her arms, and I'm like, oh yeah. So we start flailing our arms, like dropping to the floor, like going, like, you know, doing all these like random movements that don't even like correlate to the song. It's just so like weird. And then Taylor looks over, sees us, walks in our direction, and starts dancing with Fiona and me, and we're just like dancing this little trio, like, and we start doing the rap to the song where it goes like, my ex-man, like that part. So it was just so funny because I'm looking over at Fiona and she's like making like heavy breathing noises. She's like, and like dancing, like completely like in a sweat, and I'm just laughing, like I'm literally hunched over laughing so hard because she's just being so like herself. Like, this is us, like this is what we do, like this is how we dance to Taylor Swift songs. So amazing to dance and sing and laugh and cry with Taylor. Like, it was just unbelievable. Sorry for the repetitiveness of this video about saying cool, amazing, awesome. Like, if I keep saying those words, I'm sorry. Trying to go talk to Taylor, and she was already wearing, like, you know, like the Louboutin stilettos. So although she was already like, what, like 6 foot, she now became like 6'4" or something like that. Like, she was really tall, and it's like I said, I'm like 5'1", 5'2". So when I went to hug her, I was at her like stomach, chest. So I walk in and I'm like, Taylor, okay, I have 3 things I want to talk to you about. And I did take my time when I talked to her just because, like, I knew I would never get this experience again, and I really did not want to be like, oh, I wish I said that, like, oh, because I always have those moments in my life, and I'm like, let this be the one time where I don't forget to say anything that I want to say to her. And honestly, I said everything that I wanted to say to her that night. Like, I couldn't have said anything more. So I did go into some personal stuff with her, like personal things I've been dealing with and just stuff like that. So I'm really not going to go into full depth about that just because it is personal to me. So the first thing I said when I went up to her is, Taylor, I'm 100% Turkish American. And by the way, I am 100% Turkish American, like I speak fluent Turkish and English, so yeah. Because I have gotten questions about that in my previous videos. Anyway, so then I go, you know, Taylor, whenever I go to Turkey, I always ask my friends, like other people, like, oh, do you know Taylor Swift? Like, do you like her? Like, what's your views on her? And everyone's always like, oh my gosh, I'm obsessed with Taylor Swift. I love her. I love her song. She's awesome. Like, I completely, like, love her. And so I told her, I'm like, Taylor, like, Turkey thinks that you don't know about them, and I want you to know that they love you, and if you're ever planning on going some kind of international tour. And then she cut in, and she's like, I have never, like, heard about this. Like, this is brand new information to me. And I go, well, yeah, I wanted you to know, because, like, I thought that you may not know about this. So she's like, yeah, I'll keep it in, like, consideration. Like, thanks for telling me. And then the second thing I told her about was my YouTube channel, of course, because, you know, this is a pretty big part of my life, and I wanted to share that with her. And I told her, you know, like, I make beauty videos, I make fashion videos, and they're always, like, centered around you, kind of, because your style impacts me and your makeup, too. So I make makeup videos on you and, like, fashion. And she's like, oh, like, that's so cool. Like, I love watching makeup videos on YouTube. Like, I love to do it in my spare time. And she's like, you know, like, I like watching, like, the eyeliner tutorials. And I'm like, yeah, like, you're pretty known for your winged eyeliner. And then I started talking to her about the hate comments on YouTube. And because, you know, as my audience is getting larger and larger, the hate comments start to pile in a little bit more. And obviously, it's gonna hurt, like, seeing someone say something negative about a video that you worked really hard on is always gonna be upsetting. And I just told her, you know, I try to take your example and follow your lead and just completely ignore it, delete it, block it. Like, I just try to completely erase it from my mind, but obviously it hurts sometimes to see it. Like, especially if I'm having a bad day and I already see a comment like that. And she's, like, not completely 100% like understanding. And she goes, you know, I'm really worried about the YouTube section because the people on there can just be so cruel. And then to reply to that, I'm like, oh, you know, like, most of the time these people don't even have profile pictures, so it's just really funny to be like, oh, like, you're such a coward for not even saying that to my face directly without even a profile picture that I could associate yourself with. For all I know, you could be some kind of robot. And she starts laughing, and she's like, yeah, like, those people, I always imagine them to be the ones who, you know, still live with their moms at an old age, and they still have their Star Wars action figure collection going on and growing and growing. And then she, like, stops and sees me laughing, and she's like, not that Star Wars action figures are bad, but, you know, once you become so unsocial and hurtful to the point that, you know, you need to take a step back. Like I said, like, the third thing is a little bit personal, so I'm not gonna share that with you, but that's pretty much what I talked about with Taylor. And then I gave her another hug, and then she goes, okay, so what pose should we do? And I said, you know, I was thinking it'd be really cool if we could do some kind of pinky promise to show that we'd be best friends forever and ever and ever, and this picture will be proof. And she goes, I love that. And so we did the pinky promise pose, which is right here. I don't know if you guys can see, because I am using some kind of lighting here to help the video be better. So here's, like, a little more in-depth picture of it. Like, I thanked her again, and, like, I walked away, and I asked the people there, like, oh, like, can I stay and, like, watch my friend talk to Taylor? And they're like, yeah, yeah, it's fine. So then I was, like, watching Fiona talk to Taylor, and so this is what they talked about.
My best experience with Taylor by far was when I danced with her, because I am a terrible, terrible dancer, but I danced so passionately and wildly and crazily. And when Shake It Off came out, it turned into, like, a huge dance party. And I kind of knew that she was probably going to work her way around. So instead of, like, trying to push up and dance with her, I was like, you know what? I'm just going to do my own thing here. So I started flailing my limbs like crazy and just psychotically dancing. Like, I literally looked like an idiot, but it was so much fun. And by the time she got to me, she was hysterically laughing, and we ended up doing the whole rap to Shake It Off together, and she just was laughing very hard at my dancing. So then when I got to see her later and talk to her, we talked about my dancing, and she said I have a good sense of rhythm, which I'm still not sure about, but okay, Taylor, I'll take your word for it. And we took our picture together, and in the picture we were dancing together because I feel like we had a bond with that. And I asked her if we could sing the chorus to Forever and Always together, because I've, like, always wanted to, but she said that she really couldn't because there were just, like, a lot of rules and stuff. But she asked which show I'd be at, and I said that I'd probably go to a New York or New Jersey show of the of the 1989 tour. So she said that she's gonna try and do an acoustic version of Forever and Always for me at one of those shows, because she wants me to be able to hear it live. And yeah, that's most of my experience. There are a few more conversations that I had with her, but I want to keep it kind of brief. So hope you guys all enjoy, and I can't wait to watch this video when Selena edits it and puts in her story too.
Okay, and then after that, as Fiona was walking away, I go, Taylor, like, can I have like a group picture with you and Fiona? Because, you know, that'd be really cool. And Taylor goes, you know, best friends always gotta have group pictures. So then we take this group picture. So that's why I titled this one as Best Friends Have to Have Group Pics, because, you know, that's what she said, and I thought that was really cute that she did that. And I'll have you know that Taylor is a completely direct person. Like, she looks you straight in the eye. She just doesn't look at anyone else when she's talking to you. The intention is all on you. Like, I spoke with her for about like 8 to 10 minutes, I'd say, while other people maybe spoke to her for about like a minute or two. So it was really nice that she really set aside that time for me. And because I did tell her, like, oh, like, you know, like, I want to do 3 things. And after I finished talking to her about Turkey, the person taking the Polaroid picture was like, you know, like, we should take the picture now. And Taylor just completely, like, shooed her off, like, you know, like, attention's on me and just me. So that was really nice of her. If you have any questions, just leave them down below. I always check my comments and I like to reply to as many as I can. So yeah, thank you again to Taylor Swift, Taylor Nation, TaylorSwift.com, anyone who is possible for the production of this entire event. Honestly, the best night of my entire life, and I'm so happy that I got to make so many new friends, have so many new memories and experiences because of this, and now I'm such a happier person. Anyways, I will see you guys in my next video. Make sure to check out my social media, my Tumblr, which is also a Taylor Swift fan account, my Instagram, my Twitter, all of them are linked down below, so make sure to go check the down bar on the show more button. Bye, everyone!